So let's fix the first problem, which is essentially that in order to run Webspace inside of Operations Hub, it must run with encrypted credentials. So under the Security tab in the Webspace session tool, you need to change your transport to encrypted and select the encryption level that you want. And then you'll need to pick the certificate that you'll want to use. Now there's a couple of options here. The first option is if you intend to use Webspace from any browser and not just Operations Hub, what you'll want to do is go to your Webspace ISO install and run the front end. And in here you can open up a install certificates tool. From here you can actually go ahead and generate the certificate using this tool, and then restart IIS, and then you can access it from IIS or from Operations Hub. And what this does is it registers to, by default, port 443. Just be careful that you don't overwrite a port of an existing web server on this current machine. So if you had, for example, installed Operations Hub first and it had taken up port 443, you'd make this 444, etc. So that's how you would get a certificate set up and for use here. The other way to do this is actually to just reuse the CIMPLICITY certificate, which is what we're going to use. You can see we're under the CIMPLICITY install folder. We pick the CIMPLICITY certificate and we go ahead and say OK. Now the final step there is you'll need to go and stop and restart the Webspace server. So we'll do that. Then we'll go to the start utility and run that. I'm running them as administrator just to make sure that there's no permission problems. So that will take care of that first pop-up message that we got over on our Webspace, our Operations Hub server.